All right, guys. So when you open up the Notion, you first need an account. After you're gonna get this page, and when you scroll down, there's gonna be like subsections. There's journals, charts, there's models that you can create your own model or implement your model.
Hi, real quick. Can you explain what Notion is?
Yeah, so Notion is like you can basically just create like a little page, and this is like a page that I've made, just for like a trading journal. It's pretty crazy. So like it you start off, if you want to make your own page, it starts off like this. So it's like example, and you could just basically like put like lists and create like databases for your models, and like it's like it goes like there's a big rabbit hole, you know, like not rabbit hole, but it's like it gets pretty complex. But that's why, you know, like this, it took me kind of like an hour of like studying it to really put together something like this. But it's like it's obviously messy, everything's all over the place. But Notion is basically used for like documenting and like organizing like data and whatever you want to put. Like I have a journal page right here where I'm starting to write journals and stuff like that, you know. So my computer is a little laggy.
So basically, whatever we have in, say Google Docs or whatever, can be put in Notion, and it looks just like your own
Yeah, it's kind of
webpage.
like your own website, like
Okay, cool.
so yeah, so you can like, and it's to have in a select area. So like for instance, instead of having your like, let's say you have a Google Docs, like you make a new document for every single trade you make, you know, your Google Docs is gonna be scattered with all the trades you take, right? But if you go into this Notion, which this is a template, like this is, they give you like all of this. So like, look, I have for this model, I have all my trades right here. So instead of having your Google Docs all spread apart, you can have it all in this like neat organized way. And basically you can just like click on this and you'll be able to see like the screenshot. I don't know why there's no screenshot on this one. Probably forgot to put it. But you can see a screenshot of the trade you put, and you implement all of this by yourself. Like, so I'm gonna just give you an example. Like, so let's say right here, you won't have Cameron's model or a silver bullet. You'll have like a fresh one. So like new journal table template. So you create a new journal template right here. So let's say you want to record your trades. So you could put one right here. It's NQ. And you just keep going through the list of like you put the pair and queue direction long, could put your date, outcome, win or loss, and it gives you all of this. Instead, if you wanted to make this by yourself, you would have to implement all of these type of functions, which isn't hard, honestly. Because they give you everything you need, like right here. It seems confusing for someone who doesn't know how to do it, but I'm not going to take the time to explain every single thing because, you know, we don't got that time. But just for the journals, you see, so you just implement it, a long direction, a date, P&L, say we made 100, we gain 1%, you know, just keep going through the list, your risk reward, entry time frame, entry window. So like, what time did you take this? 9 o'clock. Entry time frame, 5 o'clock or 5 minutes. The day, Tuesday, and then like you could implement your model, and if you don't even, I mean like you can, I could show you guys how to implement your model into this kill zone. So they have a lot of like ICT type of things, and most of you guys trade ICT. So, but anyways, this is like a. This is how you fill out for your trading journal right here. And then when you click on the trading journal, you can go open inside Peek. If you open inside Peek, it'll have a window that pops up and you can implement your, you know, your trades. I have a lot of screenshots of trades, so I'll just put that one. So we won October 9th. You can see all this data right here. And if you want to screenshot it, if you want to share it with anyone, you can go to share, publish, and publish to web. Obviously, I'm going fast, but it's just because like there's so much information on this. I don't want to make this like a 2 hour video, you know, something that you guys can just watch and then like, okay, we click this and then we, you know, something that's fast, but it's to the point of what you need. So that's the trading journal. Is there any questions on just that?
No, it looks good. It's impressive. I didn't know what Notion was. So if you want to go back and start from the top, that'd be great.
Yeah, no problem. So this is the template that you get to start off with. And obviously it's pretty self-explanatory. This will be the journal. This would be like the your missed trades, maybe like time. You couldn't be on the charts. And so you put all your missed trades here. You could put your winning trades here just to have like a log of where all the winning trades that you took. I don't have much of the winning trades because most of the time, all my winning trades go into my journal, but obviously you can use every single one of these. And over here we have the journal tutorial. So if you wanna learn more about how to like implement it, you can go over here and it'll sh and this guy will show you in 3 minutes, like how to do the journal, how to fill out the missed trades, why is it used for. So that's kind of how I learned how to use this too, the winning trades. So the tutorial can really show you everything for the individual boxes, but like the main important stuff is obviously the trading journal, you know, trading journal and you know weekly profiles. You could put like pictures of like what the week did and stuff like that. Like so you could see is like, oh, this was FOMC week. What did it do? Oh, we usually have a spike on Tuesday, and then yeah. So like if you're and all of these have the tutorial. So if you want to just learn more about how to create your model and put it on here, you could watch this and then it'll show you how to do it. So it's like they really give you like honestly, you don't even need to watch this. You could just watch every single one of these videos right here. And it'll literally show you what to do for every single like for the forecasting. It'll go like in a minute depth of why you want to use the forecasting one to like, you know, oh, I forecast that we're gonna grab this liquidity. And it's yeah, it's not as hard once you get used to it, like pre-market routine. This one I use a lot. Like look at all these. So basically it's like for tomorrow, let's say. So I'm gonna just go over here. This is like the calendar because this is September. Right here, so it's September and it's October. So Tuesday I didn't trade, but like for let's say for Monday today. So you can drag the Monday from here and drag it back onto the Monday like today. And you can click on the Monday and you can it has questions all filled out for you. So you know like what is a high impact news driver that you should be aware of on no news. Or you could say like Israel, conflict. What's a draw on liquidity? You know, you go to your charts and you can, oh, what's a draw on liquidity for today? What should I be aware of? Oh, this downside draw on liquidity is the buy side draw on liquidity. What's the daily bias? And then you can have your before screenshots and after screenshots. So just to show you. So like, this was last Friday. I was aware of like these type of draw on liquidities. I also like marked off. I was like, oh, there's an efficiently traded range up here, and there's like an imbalance right here. And then you could put the before screenshot and then the after screenshot. Honestly, sometimes I'm lazy to put the after screenshot, or like I'd literally just forget. But that's helpful to like figure out. I was like, oh, was my analysis correct on this day? And was it not? You know, that's pretty important. I should start doing that. But yeah, so the pre-market analysis is really important. So I do that every single day before I trade. And then you could do the end of week reviews, forecasting, and then like I'll just quickly show you how to implement your model. So like this is like a new model that I was working on. Bizcard and then like a Silver Bullet. So it's basically kind of the same as the trading journal. You just go into it and you can mark off like okay, this is a screenshot number 3. Mark off like the fundamentals. Like fundamentally, I was bullish because of interest rates, your entry time frame, your time that you entered on 10 o'clock, let's say for Silver Bullet. Was the market trending, reverse, was it a reversal, was it a consolidation? So like it literally gives you all of these stuff. You don't have to go and like so and type it out all out. So it's like literally just, I feel like the easiest way is just like reading what these do and then just taking your time and opening it right here where it says open. Put your screenshots, put the type, fill these out, and you could have like a little name right here. So like just to show you what a new one would look like, since you guys probably don't have it. So you put your model name here. What type of model is it? The summary of a model, like sentence. Oh, this is a drawn liquidity model, so you put this in the market conditions, and then you could just fill it out. And then I think I have one for Forex that's completely filled out. So it just keeps this, the reason why this is valid, because it just keeps everything in just one area. So this is a silver bullet drawn liquidity model that I had. And you can go to the gallery. You could see all the screenshots right here. Obviously, you can't really see it well, but if you like zoom in, you could probably see it better. Yeah, so like zoom in, you could see all your screenshots of what you did without having to click on individual ones. So this one I took a loss. This one I took a win. So it just honestly is just for, instead of having like Google Docs, everything is just spread apart. It's just helpful. But is there anything specifically that you guys found confusing while using this? Or did this kind of help? I know I was probably going fast, but I just don't want to go through literally every single one of them because we're gonna be here for like 2 hours.
It's fast, but it did help.
It did
Yeah,
help.
you lightning speed with that jelly. But yeah, I just set mine up yesterday though, so.
Yeah, so like I know I'm going fast, but if you go to the journal tutorials, like right here, like
Yeah.
every one of them has a tutorial section. So let's say just for the chart tutorials. All right, breakdowns. And then in 40 seconds, he's gonna explain why this is important. Like I'll just watch this real quick.
So next up, we have breakdowns within the purple section, the charts, really simple. Let's put in pair, Euro USD. The tag for this one, I am going to do Asian range, Judas, and New York continuation. If we go inside, the screenshot which I've got here is just of that. We can go to gallery view, and as you can see, it's right there. That is pretty much it. If you want to add anything on here, obviously there's
So yeah, so this for the chart breakthroughs, breakdowns, right here, you could just like, oh, if you want to study, if you want to take a picture of like power of three, I don't think I even have anything here, but I have one thing. So you can go in and just add all this stuff. The reason I don't have every single thing is because obviously like there's so many other, like it's kind of redundant because you have breakdowns, but then you also have like tape reading, which you can put on. So and then you also have like your missed trades, like oh, this is a trade I could have took, or you know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of stuff that's kind of like you could use for other stuff, like for tape reading, put everything that you've seen, like rebalance. I noticed this pattern, you know, back hindsight. So I just put it on type reading. So yeah, I hope this helped, but if it didn't, just go through the routines and like the most important ones, forecasting, pre-market routines, end of week routine, and putting your model on one of these, and then like you know going through and you can like back test and fill this out, and then yeah, and then obviously the journal, and missed trades if you want. I feel like those are the most important ones. Because you can get overwhelmed if you just use every single one of these. Obviously, that's probably the point of it, to use every single one. That's probably what Everett does. Everett's probably like shaking his head right now. He's like, yo, it's Jelly's slacking right now. But yeah, journal, models, and then all of these are really important for the routine. And yeah, just click on the tutorials. It'll show you a little demonstration. And yeah, I hope this helped though, guys.
Thank you so much, Jelly. I have a question. Where can we find the link? And did you say there was a subscription-based program?
No, this is completely free. I forgot to mention that. This is like
okay.
free, which is really cool. And Everest has posted on the Discord. But yeah, I'm gonna upload this to YouTube so y'all have it, like it'll always be there. Yeah, right here. I don't know if you guys can see it. You just posted in general. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna go make some breakfast though. I hope you guys have a good day.
Hey, you say you're gonna post this on YouTube, Jelly?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let me start recording. No problem. Thank you, guys.